Dear students, this video is for the beginners. Those who are coming for the first time in the chemistry lab will find many glassware kept on long tables. The tables on which the glassware are kept are called working tables. Here I have brought some of the glassware to make you learn the names of those glassware and where these glassware are employed. So we'll start with this stand and the clamp on which you can see the burette is kept. This iron stand has a clamp, and this clamp is movable up or down. To adjust the position of the burette, we can open the clamp and put the burette in this position. A white tile is always required, because whenever we go for the titration, the change in the color is noticed easily if the tile below is white. A pipette. This is a bulb pipette or a belly pipette. We can also use a graduated pipette in which the graduations are there. The graduated pipette is a narrow tube without bulb, and there are graduations. But here there is only one single mark above the belly. When the solution is sunk into the pipette, the solution should reach this mark. The lower part is tapering, and the solution is taken out from the pipette from below. Burette is a long slender graduated cylinder. When we fill the solution, it should reach here up to the zero mark, and the below mark is 25 ml. So there are burettes which are having a capacity of 50 ml or 10 ml. So depending upon the use, we go for different capacity of burettes and pipettes. A conical flask. The conical flask is conical in shape with a small narrow mouth. We take the solution with the help of funnels. So this is a plastic funnel. We can also go for a glass funnel. When we put the funnel, it should be kept like this. This is the right way of putting the funnel. If we put it like this, it may roll down, and if it falls, then it may break into pieces, and the students working in the lab may get hurt. So for lower classes, we usually give the plastic funnels. But yes, we can use the glass funnels also. This is a glass rod made of solid glass. To prepare the solution, we take the salt in the conical flask or in the beaker, and after pouring the water or the solvent, we keep stirring with the help of this rod to dissolve it, unless it is completely into the solution. Now this is the beaker. The beaker can be starting from 1 ml to many liters, because the beaker has a small beak or a spout. A pout here, so we call it a beaker. It has a wide mouth, and we normally use these beakers to prepare the solutions. This is a test tube. Now this test tube is used for various purposes. During the salt analysis, the salt is taken in the test tube, and with the help of this test tube holder, whose the other part is made up of wood, and there is one sliding lock is there, with the help of which we'll just put the test tube in the holder and lock it like this, so that when we are heating this test tube on the flame, our hands are away from the flame and will not get burnt. This is a dropper. If we want to take some solution, small amount, we can simply press this rubber bulb on the top and take the solution, and then we can pour it slowly drop wise in the other apparatus. And this is normally used for the introduction of indicator. This is a spatula. This spatula has a small bowl shaped structure here, and this is for holding. So we can take out the salt with the help of the spatula in the weighing bottle. This is a small glass weighing bottle. We can also use plastic bottles. It is made up of fragile glass, and the salt is taken, like I have taken potassium dichromate salt. So we can take a small amount of salt with the help of spatula and then weigh it on the weighing machine. This is a standard or volumetric flask. The lower end is modified into a pear-shaped structure. Upper side is a long narrow neck. There is a mark always on the volumetric flask. So whenever we are preparing the solution should always reach up to the mark, and that shows the capacity of the solution in the volumetric flask. It is always provided with a lid, so that after making the solution up to the mark, it should be mixed thoroughly to make the solution homogeneous. Now this is the measuring cylinder. Of course, this is a cylinder which is a graduated cylinder, and this is employed for taking the solvent or the solution in the required amount. We use these measuring cylinders. It can be of glass or it could be of plastic. This is called the reagent pot. In the reagent bottles, the reagents are kept. Whatever reagents are required in the labs, like solutions of potassium dichromate, sodium chloride, sodium hydroxide, potassium hydroxide, or any other solution, we use these reagent bottles. They are also called sample bottles. And a very important part of the lab is the wash bottle. These are made up of plastic. It has the body and long plastic tube. If we squeeze this bottle in the beaker or in the conical flask, we can take out the bottle by squeezing it. So these are all the glass lids which are generally employed in any lab, and especially the chemistry lab.